too.
All right. All right, there you go.
All right, Jack.
All right, I'm eating a tamale.
Chew into the lapel. Chew into the lapel.
Well, the adventure part hasn't even started. This is the warm up, basically. This is actually the frustrating part. Well, the trip's also the frustrating part, but this is the more frustrating part.
So what's fun if it's all frustrating?
It's simultaneously frustrating and fun.
Cut that wire. It's so close to like.
You should try and get a sponsorship from HEB sparkling water.
Dude, they're probably begging us for one.
Cases upon cases of them.
Is that good?
Wait, we should. That should be a good question. What's your favorite HEB sparkling water flavor?
I think grapefruit's the only right and just answer.
Wait, no, dude. Any other answer?
I'm gonna be in a terrible mood for parts of this rafting trip. Oh, I'm scared of my camera falling in the water. That's what I'm scared of. That's my biggest fear.
Yeah, why are you doing this?
I don't know. It's like scary because I know I'm gonna want to do like job things the next few summers. This is the last summer I can get away with not doing it.
I'm doing it because it sounded cool. This raft behind me, just having it is probably the most satisfying thing ever, knowing that I built it with my own two hands, and that, like, barring anything happening with the motor, it runs well.
That was funny.
What's going on? What are we working on?
You know the drill. You know the drill.
Funny.
Oh shit,
the woods.
Wait, dude, I actually get it.
Ouchie.
Ned, you fucking broke the raft. I'm about one
got
more
the tent going.
Permanently sending him back to Dallas. by Greyhound bus. Actually really scared me, Ned. I feel like you have it in you.
Dude, there's something in your ear, Jack.
Jack is tries to like take over things. Tries to commandeer it, like everything.
You just have to say his name. Nedward Spurgeon Newton, and you'll get a great idea of Ned.
I don't know. Ned's one of those people you meet, and he really just does not care about a lot of things that a lot of people care about.
McCoy once said to me that he likes people who do not fit into one sentence, and I think McCoy is one of those people.
Just an absolute menace, man. That's who. He's full of shit. I'd be accurate too.
Well, I'm building a houseboat in heaven to sail them deep and holy seas. Well, I'm building a houseboat in heaven. And it's welcome aboard your sweet, sweet peas. Well, the bow, she is made of solid silver. And the hull, she is made of solid gold. And she ain't too much along the lines of floating. And she's yours, babe, to have and to hold.
Pretty skeletal, I would say. And it's just to put the raft on. What is it, Red Oak?
Yeah, like 65 miles south of Shreveport.
65 miles south of Shreveport, and then go down to New Orleans. That's the plan. Easy money.
Oh, maybe I'm not cautious enough, but there's nothing that I'm like, oh no, alligators, like. It's because I don't know what to expect. Like, I don't know what to be afraid of.
You learn life lessons. You learn how to construct and how to ask people for free shit. That was a big one.
It's not even that Ned's gonna be the first to drown, or like there's a possibility, he's gonna be the only death, and he will be the one that drowns.
This is the last summer for all of us to just kind of do whatever we want before we start our lives in the real world, like trying to get internships or jobs that apply like toward our futures. This is the summer to do it.
I got an email from the executive producer of Channel 5 News in Alexandria.
That would be the best part of the documentary. It's like news opening, and then it's like, and Channel 5 News, look at this, the tequila shark. Dude, they probably won't even put it on there once they hear the name.
Like, our first thought was, these guys are gonna die. Like, we thought you guys were gonna die.
It was cool. Everybody thought you were gonna die before you got to New Orleans.
It is fixing to be bad, bad weather.
Did you think we might die?
Yeah.
What do you think, Ned? Do you think we're gonna get there
early? I'm glad we can get there.
We're not gonna get there early, but I think we're gonna get there.
Yeah.
Okay. After the way today went down, I was a lot more reassured this morning than I have been.
Yeah, we're gonna get there, all right.
Because people were telling us.
That's so cool.
His uncle was saying.
My uncle, who has like boated this river and done this trip like multiple times, supposedly, not supposedly, he has, was like, yeah, there's no way it's gonna take you 3 weeks, and we are scheduled to do it in like 7 days.
Oh my God, dude, bananas so bad.
Dude, we didn't need anything. We could have literally just gotten on here. No food, no water, no sleep, just fuel. Or I guess fuel and water. We could have made it in like 2 days.
We could probably get to Alexandria in 30 minutes.
We did this really weird thing to get the trailer down involving rope and rock, but it wasn't that exciting. What was exciting is when the boat got in the water and didn't sink. We got the motor started. We were cruising. And, I was trying to fix it or keep it running, and Ned and McCoy were so excited that they missed the alligator that we almost ran over.
Oh no, you guys, you can't like not tell me where I'm going.
Which was directly in front of us and pretty much could have ate us all alive. And then we almost slammed into the banks of the river, and that was the very, very beginning of the trip. I don't understand how you could possibly spin this to not be your fault.
You said your piece. So, you playing that song inspired me to pull out my camera and start filming, which then inspired Jack to run over an alligator.
Jack is a homicidal maniac who likes killing endangered species.
I think that's
my guy, dude. That's pretty fucked up. Jack, I didn't know you were the bad guy here. Shit.
This raft would not exist without me, okay?
Okay, so now you're a bad guy and you have this huge ego.
No comment. That's not an alligator, is it?
No.
You're looking for your next target, huh?
Got the outboard motor started. It's a puppy. And then,
we were just like, hey, fuck it.
Yeah, we were going, dude. It was really vibey.
It was actually so vibey.
It was cool. We had some good music playing. And the trolley motor's running. Then we got the engine started, and it was still vibey, but less music and more just sitting outside in the dark. And then we almost got hit by a barge.
That barge was small. It was a soft barge.
Soft barge, yeah. Compared to this thing, wouldn't stand a chance.
This could be truly disastrous.
Dude, we're gonna dock in 5 minutes.
Okay.
Comes the wake.
I work for Alexandria Police Department. I'm a corporal here. I've been working here for 5 years, and I've been law enforcement for 20. And I work out of City Hall here, and I ride around in my local boat down here. And I deal with the homeless a lot. Everybody down here just calls me direct. They don't even call 911 or the police department. They just call me. When I seen it coming, I didn't know what it was. And then y'all docked down there. I had to go look at it. Just found a homemade boat that y'all were traveling on.
Run the motor much, or y'all just letting the current take it?
We're running almost.
Really? Yeah. I'll give you a ride if y'all need to go get something right now.
Y'all were obviously needing to get to a store. So I think I took you to get gas and to the dollar store, and Dylan took somebody later on at the Walmart, I think. Heck, and I went and got y'all some water, because I figured y'all were going to die of thirst in the heat out there, too. Yeah.
This guy emailed us. Here are these guys that are floating down the river on their own boat, and I think it's a really cool idea if anyone on that stretch can come pick it up.
Actually, again, I'm on the other side. I'm where y'all sitting, so it's kind of different sitting in this spot being interviewed.
Have you ever made a boat?
No.
The boys are traveling from Shreveport to New Orleans carrying the standards, food, water, and gas. Now, of course, it hasn't been all smooth sailing, encountering barges, alligators, and mosquitoes.
That was literally the most stressful thing I've ever done in my entire life.
But they're just hoping to finish the journey. Reporting in Alexandria, Dylan Domingue, News Channel 5, your local station.
Yeah, the guys actually got their boat legally registered, and they said if they make it to New Orleans, their idea would be to take the boat into the James River in Virginia and then travel to the Atlantic Ocean. Pretty cool stuff.
We'll be right back.
This is probably a once in a reporter's lifetime type story. To have a story this unique. You know, there's always unique stories kind of coming out about different people overcoming things, different things like that. You hear about three guys in college that all met, not from here, nowhere from this area, wanting to go on this journey. This is definitely it's a rare story.
The night in Alexandria.
There's not very many, but yes, we have been.
I was about to say stop in Natchez. If you've ever been to Natchez, it's a lot of fun.
But where is that?
It's north.
Okay.
You would have missed it already.
Is there any good place to stop from here on out, pretty much?
Oh, from here to the end of the Red River? No.
Yeah. I first heard about you when you guys went through Lock 1. The lock master for Lock 1 called and said, we've got three guys on a homemade raft that looks like it's about to fall apart, headed down the river. It's kind of one of those situations. So depending on when you came through and depending on what they had planned for the day, you probably just screwed up their whole day. So that's pretty much what it was.
If you get there, it's a little bit of a trek from that bridge, but if you walk up to the thing, there's a small town called Effie.
Yeah.
And there's a store, a really good convenience store there where you can get gas, and they got really good loaded baked potato wedges that are like out of this world.
Oh, there is an eddy, they said, at the last spot. This one too.
Dude, we're so close to it.
Is it just hauling gravel?
It's not coal, dude. That's like gravel.
I said gravel.
They said coal. It's like,
oh, yeah.
I wonder how much money you'd make if you just started selling a shit ton of gravel. That's the easy. I feel like you could so easily do that. It's fucking everywhere.
You know how hard it is to get gravel?
You did SOS. You did it twice.
You dumb dumb.
Dude, what the hell?
They don't think I'm good.
Like, by Three Rivers, Wildlife Management, but then there's the one below that, which is the old river. Dude, are we going through the old river tonight?
I have no... That's on navigation, dude.
Ned, are we going through the old river or the Three Rivers?
Old river.
Is the old river... Damn, we do have to go through a lock then. So last night, starting at like 1, we started going up the spillway. Take us to a lock tip of the Mississippi River. Going up, finding a place to camp. It's the morning after, we can take this lock. But as soon as we're about to get to our campsite, our motor just cuts out and stops working. So right then, we have to paddle over against the current, tie off, set up a tent. Sleep about 3 hours.
What time do we go to bed?
5 o'clock in the morning. Try the motor again, push it out, no luck. So we have to flag down another motorist.
Is this rope here is tied in.
Okay, that's good. So untie that what he's got and tie that green rope.
I did just have a shit ton of duct tape around it and it was working earlier.
This is a great call. I think this will save us a lot of time and energy.
Sir, we should trade engines.
It's time to 15 grand, so you write me a check. We'll talk it out.
Right now, our best bet, when he offered to go drive us to get a fuel line 40 minutes away, which is incredibly nice of him, but we got it, our work cut out for us today, needless to say.
I can't decide whether we should go to,
you have to make multiple trips, or
yeah, I don't want to make him do that, so maybe one person should go. But it's gonna be really risky if it's not the fuel line.
Let's see, are we gonna need cash at this place?
What cash? I already know. I mean, it's gonna be a Walmart store. I'm sure they sell at wood. How old is that motor?
Oh, the motor's
pretty old.
Very old.
Y'all doing any maintenance to it?
It's a 1986. There's a decent amount of work into it, but not a ton. Just enough to get it like running and functioning well.
That's a bad input.
All right.
Tell them thanks.
Thank you guys very much for saving our entire trip. We appreciate it.
I kind of envy y'all, man, that I didn't do this when I was
younger. Hey, you should just build one now.
I'm too old, and wood is too expensive. You ready?
To make sure this doesn't smack us.
Yeah.
Also,
yeah.
We have these things, so we don't want to put
this
those.
This is all hands on deck, no phones.
We got that.
Yeah, get those over there. Get those over
get
there.
Get that over here. I don't know where the other one's at, but.
Oh my god. Holy fuck.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
McCoy, film upways for the Instagram.
Oh my god.
The Mississippi River.
Those noises came from hell.
Literally, what hell sounds like.
Okay.
Dude, the Coast Guard.
Hi.
Doing all right?
Doing us good.
We're letting our motor cool off right now.
Okay. Dude, is that a shark?
Is that a shark? Oh my god.
It's not what? A shark.
Why
sure?
is it floating like Pause vertically like
shark.
That? Why is it standing vertically? Dude, why does it look like that? You know? Whatever. It's not gonna affect us. I don't think.
It's a bull shark.
Anyways.
Until you're ready to take it off.
Okay. All right. Okay.
Pull that one, it'll come off.
Okay. Sounds good.
Anything to say to the camera?
I wish y'all was in this boat and I was in that one.
Are you guys from Baton Rouge?
Mm-hmm.
Both of you?
Yep.
Born and raised
here. That's awesome.
So where are y'all from?
I'm from San Antonio, Texas.
Okay.
I'm from Fort Worth.
Fort Worth?
And I'm from Indiana.
Well, I saw that phone number.
Yeah.
It's not, yeah.
Everybody has on LSU clothes. LSU people fly their colors. That's cool. My name's Kelly Walker, my wife Julie, and we actually knew each other. We went to high school together. We've been married for almost 30 years. Both of us were born and raised here in Baton Rouge.
I saw it on the news and I was like, man, that's really a cool idea. These guys built this raft. And I told my husband, I said, you know, there's some guys and they built this raft and they're floating down the Mississippi and they're supposed to be in Baton Rouge about 4:00. I said, the news is encouraging everybody to go down and meet them. I said, why don't we go? And he was like, okay.
We were actually supposed to go to a wedding the night we met y'all. And we called the people that said, we're not going to be at your wedding. Y'all needed some Chick-fil-A. I mean, we had to.
To go down the Mississippi River.
So do y'all want to go to the firehouse first?
Yeah.
That'd be incredible.
That'd be awesome.
Three shifts. You work 24 hours a day.
You're up 24 hours straight when you're on?
Yeah, well, we came in this morning and we get off tomorrow morning.
Wow. Okay. Well,
where y'all from?
Oh, nice.
He's from San
Antonio. All the steam too and everything.
Sir.
Yeah. I think it's pretty cool too that y'all got to see the true side of humanity also. I mean, y'all got help from total strangers all along the route. Just people that came up and said, hey, or you stopped and said, can you help us? I think that's pretty awesome.
we just actually, if you wanted to follow our, we have an Instagram account called tequila.shark.
I'll pull it up. I don't know if I'll follow it.
That's fair. Pure day.
All stations. Oh, they asked for your parents' phone number. I was telling them like, something ridiculous, like they don't use phones or something.
Our families are Amish.
Yeah. Who's the owner of the vessel?
It's registered under my name, but McCoy's the operator of the boat.
How big is it? So you said you have three people, you're gonna have three?
Yes.
Sure.
Do you see three life jackets? Do you have a horn with one more?
Yeah, yes. We have a horn. You want me to blow it?
Sure, go for it.
Maybe. For real.
Okay. I think we're all right. Absolutely screwed.
What's gonna be like? What am I gonna do? You know?
Dude, I'm gonna just be sleeping in a coma for a long time, and then I'm gonna get a job.
It's gonna be not as fun as this.
That's true.
I'll probably just be reminiscing the whole summer.
It's gonna be like kind of sad. Honestly.
We'll edit the documentary.
We will.
In the director's cut, there's gonna be a special voiceover of me going, "Ned sucks at using the lighter. Sucks." You're fine with it sinking?
I mean, at this point, I'm like half ready to get off of this thing.
Yeah, that's fair.
Also, the way just today, being so tired and it's been so hot. I'm ready to see New Orleans. Ready to get a beignet.
Yeah.
Breaker, breaker, this is Tequila Shark to Baby Tug. Tequila Shark to Baby Tug. Your cylinders are firing a little hot. If you could just slow down a little bit so we don't end up in the bottom of the sip. Thank you. Ned, how's the back of the boat doing?
Not great, but honestly, I don't care. We're there. There's too much confusion.
Ned's on the biggest high of his life right now.
Let's go.
He earned it.
Nolans! We met new people every single day. There wasn't a day that we didn't meet new people.
I don't advise anybody to do this, but I was like, look, if you got a couple guys and you're determined to go do it and you want to make it happen, just go do it. You know, they have an idea. They might not know how to fully go through with it. They might just find out and learn along the way, but I mean, they can get it done.
We had a guy there at the lock who, for the next several days, he talked about you guys and some of the stuff that he did growing up, and he wished growing up that he would have did more.
But y'all's little trip was one of the coolest, I guess, I've come across. No, it was. That was really cool. I wouldn't even have thought of that, especially when I went down the Mississippi River and that thing.
One thing, I'm not a big believer in chance or circumstance. Things happen in your life for a reason and purpose. People cross your path for a reason and purpose. So I look at this and say, wow, this is pretty awesome. We got to meet these guys that, who would have done that? But more so, I look at it and say, how awesome is it that we got to meet y'all? And not only have we had the opportunity to help y'all that day, but y'all have added to our life, so it's pretty awesome.
Every boat that would come through would be like, did you guys see the barge? They made it to this spot, or they made it to this spot. So if they were on the Red River until you guys got out of that system, most of them knew exactly where you guys were at all times.
You know, it catches your eye. It's not something that you see every single day, especially from my perspective, you know. When people in Alexandria and Central Louisiana usually see my work, it's crime, politics, or sports. So when this story kind of came out, people kind of were drawn to it. I think it was one of the most read pieces that I've done here.
Things like these, the beauty of it is nothing can ever go wrong, you know? They just always work without a hitch, these types of plans. I mean, everything was so well thought out and well constructed, there's just no chance of failure or problems.
Working toward a goal that's like a self-designated goal and actually seeing it through, it's a really good feeling. Especially when it comes down to like constructing something, not like just buying something. Like, we built that thing.
Scary thinking of like being old and like not having done a lot of cool things. So I wanna be, you know, and make the most of my freshman year. I just built a raft and took it to New Orleans. Like, you can't, like, no one can take that away from you once you did it, which is cool.
People cross your path for a certain reason. It's not just by random. And what you do with those people is you add something to their life and they add something to your life. We basically help each other become a little better version of who we are. Sweet, well, I'm building a houseboat in to sail them deep and holy seas. Well, I'm building a houseboat in heaven, and it's welcome aboard your sweet, sweet peace.
If you don't know by now, and ain't no use to sit and wonder why, baby. It'll never do somehow. When your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window and I'll be gone. You're the reason I'm a traveling on. Don't think twice, it's all right. Side of the road, but I wish there was something you would do to save. Try and make me change my mind to stay. We never did too much talking anyway. Don't think twice, it's all right. It's alright.